dream is real.
Get up, get up, get up.
It's about to go down.
Newsflash.
Wake up, wake up, wake up.
Yeah. Slacking on your pimping. Turn it up.
You know, if you're gonna shoot, you better shoot straight, because a wounded animal is the worst thing you can deal with.
Facts.
This is Baller Alert Radio, featuring your lifestyle specialist, Kitty Burns, with Sue Solo and Ferrari Simmons.
The dream is real.
Oh, why you make that face, Octavia Burns?
I don't know what beat I was on.
Was that the Harlem Shake? It looked like
it was a combination.
LA dance mixed with the...
with, you know, Habesha culture and, you know, Habesha.
Okay, great. It's your lifestyle specialist, Kitty Burns.
Your boy,
Nation.
Ferrari Simmons.
Ferrari!
And your favorite Ethiopian, Sue Solo.
I'm good at that shit. I said that shit in the club last night.
Actually,
you did your thing.
I noticed that last episode. She didn't even put the thing under the voice. You carried the whole joint. You did it in the club last
night? That's that practice.
I did it in the club last night.
You must have been around some beautiful Habesha women.
Yes,
they own Atlanta.
Always the producer, yes.
Mm-hmm.
How was your weekend, Rari Simmons?
You know what? I know this sounds crazy. I got the Super Nintendo Classic, right? The little mini one.
Oh. Okay.
And I hacked it.
How?
I put 700 Super Nintendo games on it.
What? Are you serious?
The dude at the store was like, yo, if you go to YouTube, they can show you how to hack it.
So you're on tape saying it. Okay, great.
Nintendo. Yeah, I was like, don't say the dude at the store said it.
So you just YouTube it. I got every game that ever came up.
So you found that on your own. The man who sold you the system did not tell you.
He pulled me to the side. Yeah, he pulled me to the side. I was like, why don't we
show your nephews. You got to show your nephews.
Right,
cool. 700 games.
Right.
How was your weekend, baby face?
Yeah, brunch was popping, of course, at BQE Saturday. And then I had two baby showers on Sunday.
Somebody getting pregnant.
A lot of people are getting pregnant. Shout out to Yemi and Disa, thanks for having me.
No pull out game.
Warm me out, but no, it was weak.
Who's the leader of the no pull out game? I'm just maybe Ocho Cinco.
Ooh.
All right, great. So, how?
And we just gonna go on to you, Kenny Burns, lifestyle specialist. Yeah. How was your weekend?
Yeah, I just want to say this publicly now on Baller Alert Radio to Baller Nation. My new slogan in the club is somebody's getting pregnant. I swear to God, the dream is real. We still say that.
Touch yourself.
But the new one is somebody getting pregnant. I promise you, somebody in New Orleans is pregnant right now in 9 months.
Because of you.
Yeah, absolutely. I encourage sexual relations that lead to the birth of beautiful black kings and queens. But big shout out to my brother, Larry Monroe. Larry Monroe celebrated his birthday.
That was Larry.
Yeah.
Larry
turned,
he celebrates it every year with a young Angela Yee down there. We had Envy.
Did you just
Ross.
Say Angela what?
Angela Yee.
Oh, okay.
What'd I say?
You know, black people, we just submerged.
Let it ride on.
Angela Yee. You know.
Yeah, one word, Angela Yee, happy Capricorn in the building. But, you know, I love New Orleans.
Mm.
And New Orleans is one of them cities that give you that vibe. You know what I'm talking about? It's a party vibe.
Like, even though they lost, but go ahead.
Yeah, they lost. Ooh, that was petty.
Blew that. Blew that.
But that was it. We're going to talk about that in case you missed, because that was one of the best. But I love New Orleans. You know what I'm saying? And it's not because of the crawfish and the food. You know what I'm saying? I'm not even one to eat all that, which is amazing, and people do.
Yeah.
But the people... party!
Yeah,
I'm talking about they have a great time, and I just felt that in the middle of the night I need to tell everybody somebody's getting pregnant, and it just felt like it. So I'm gonna go forth into the rest of the world. I'm going to Detroit this weekend to the auto show. Somebody getting pregnant in Detroit, and in 9 months after I say this shit, I want all the people that's pregnant to come back and give me a high five. You know what
I'm saying? He got gifts for y'all. He got baby
gifts.
Okay,
that should be like November-ish, right?
You need to be on October. Point with the dates, guys.
I got something to talk about with Donald Trump, y'all. But let's get into In Case You Missed It.
Just in case you missed it.
I am here to say, as a conspiracy theorist, that Donald Trump is trying to kill us.
Donald who?
Donald.
He trying to get us killed.
Way to correct me.
Touch me.
Put the shit emoji on the screen.
Yeah, put the shit emoji on the screen. But he's trying to kill us. I think the flu virus going around was injected by Donald Trump. Okay, maybe not. But I was feeling a little under the weather, and I never get sick. And it was 2 days before I was supposed to go to New Orleans, and I was feeling the way.
He was trying to shut you down.
I think he was trying to shut me down. Mm-hmm. So Donald Trump kissed my ass. And also, he's trying to say in the news that he is not a racist.
Boy, if you don't get...
He's absolutely racist. He's no secret.
You know, racists say that when...
That's what a racist says.
That is the truth.
Yep.
Racists say I'm not a racist.
How do you...
A scammer say they're not a scammer.
You call shithole... You call African country shitholes. Mm-hmm. You call Haiti a shithole. How are you not a racist? Mm. How are you not a racist?
Well, he's not racist, he says, because he would accept people from Norway.
I don't even want to go down the long laundry list of, of racial things he says or has said. But somebody needs to do something about it. What? And on Martin Luther King birthday, first of all, I am sorry, Martin Luther King. Happy birthday.
Yes, sir.
MLK Day.
I am sorry. Happy birthday to one of the greatest leaders the free world has ever known.
But this is where we are now.
But this leader we got now.
Yeah.
What in the Waka Flocka? I'm confused. And why is it still being accepted?
I feel like we forgot about the impeachment process.
No,
like,
who forgot?
Did we just stop?
It's past impeachment.
What's going on right now? Like, has the process just stopped?
I said he needed to turn into the bluffs last week.
I'm joking, by the way.
You know that wasn't going to happen.
I'm not.
He messed up traffic. Did y'all see my Instagram post last week?
Yes.
It was bad.
Bruh, they stopped 75 for a good 45
Legit
minutes.
Legit stopped. You were nobody moved. On there.
Everyone knew it was him.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone was honking their horns so bad. It was really bad.
Okay, I can't stand talking about him no more. One time for Tiana Taylor. Please.
That's the homie.
I don't know if you saw the picture on a deck of some yacht somewhere in the world, but I was confused at first. Clearly, her body's amazing.
It was perfect.
I mean, it is amazing. I mean, the bounce back, the snap back is real. But then they cut off the feet into a Ball Alert posted the picture. Then she got pretty feet. She got pretty feet.
Yeah, but
how she got the body and the feet? Normally, it's disproportion.
That's a unicorn.
Tiana Taylor, you are a motherfucking unicorn. You deserve all the praise.
Pretty feet are hard to come by, too. Yeah.
No, listen, please.
I am a pretty feet connoisseur.
I think especially when they dance so much, like when it's an artist and they're in heels so much, you don't really expect them to have pretty feet, but she does.
You got to have pretty feet, though.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to tell you why. Because if you don't take care of your feet, 9 times out of 10, you don't take care of your house.
Or that box.
I was going to say.
High five! I didn't want to say.
Hey, zoom in on my face.
Let's stay.
You're not going to leave me hanging?
They catfishing. Oh,
okay, hold on. All right. Yeah, because that's true. I wanted to say that.
Stop catfishing.
But it's true.
Yeah.
How you going to have
the feet, baby?
And see, my mama feet is deformed. Like, they're not ugly. She wears her proper side, but it's just, she used to scare me with the motherfucker. So as I grew up, she used to literally do the shit and just talk to me when I swear to God. But I promise you, and that's why my foot fetish came about.
That's how she got you back right.
But I agree with young Rari Simmons.
Yeah.
You are absolutely correct. That means your box is a little
catfish.
Shithole. All right.
Wow. I love me some catfish, though. In real
catfish. Damn. Paris Jackson robbed after picking up hitchhikers. Where in the fuck
did
you pick up hitchhikers in 2018?
You know, people still do that.
Wealthy people do shit like that. Privileged or very wealthy, ignorant people do that.
In nice, low-crime areas, they do that still.
Very wealthy people do that.
You don't do that in the hood, obviously.
Nah.
That's why we not used to.
My mom used to make me watch Unsolved Mysteries anytime I wanted to go outside.
Bro, she's a woman first and foremost. How do you picking up hitchhikers as a woman?
Listen, oh my God, they need help.
So privileged.
Oh my God, let me pull over.
I have so much to give this world. Let me help this hitchhiker.
She is Michael Jackson.
Bro, I will roll down a window and drop a 20.
Her dad wrote the song "Heal the World." Okay?
Look.
Okay, that's a mistake. Young Paris Jackson. And then she was did you read the caption on Ball Alert? She really went to town. Like, they stole my fucking debit card after I fucking gave them. She was F-bomb dropping like a mother sucker. But big shout to Paris Jackson and her kind heart. This is not your daddy's era, though.
No.
God rest the dead. Okay, Offset. Offset.
Woo, woo, woo.
He tattooed Cardi B on his neck. He tattooed Cardi B on his neck. Robbie, I want you and I. I want us to just back up for 2 seconds and let the women have at this. What does it mean for your man to tattoo?
The neck tattoo, though.
Yeah, the neck joint.
That's a visible tat.
Yeah, that's promo.
I think that is beautiful hood love.
If you tattoo someone on your person, you love them.
It's something else to flash, I think, for them, right? Like, they're flashing so much jewelry and cars that they're buying each other. Now it's like,
but he legit,
my man got my name on his neck.
He legit told me personally, that he really loves her. Like,
no, yeah, we believe that. He said,
and I believe that. Yeah. But and tattooing someone on your person is forever. I mean,
on your neck, though, like, it's a big deal.
It's
like,
not forever anymore.
Just like Chris Brown did Rihanna's.
But it's a gesture.
Battered face.
Amber Rose had Wiz's whole face. And, you know, you got Jhené Aoki with, what you call his face?
Big Sean.
Big Sean.
Wait, she tatted Big Sean's
face? A whole Kenny, a whole thing.
A face. His face.
A whole thing on her, right here.
His face.
Are you serious?
And it looks actually good. It actually looks good.
Wow.
Yeah, she went to like his great
face,
tattoo
a portrait
artist.
Of his face on her arm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. All right.
Party with Cardi.
Yeah, he definitely is party with Cardi for the rest of his life. Even party with the and that's the thing too. You can't cover stuff like that up because it's still
party with Cardi.
I mean, you can Safari cover Nicki Minaj's face.
Okay, you're right.
He can absolutely cover that up. Any tattoo can be.
I love the Rari. The Rari Offset.
He know all the words.
Memes over there. You know every fucking word.
Shout out Cardi and Offset.
Yeah,
absolutely. Cardi.
We love them. So what if you saw an Amber Alert flash across the screen? Oh, that is a good tattoo.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. So on the back forearm.
Detailed.
That is
line.
Very.
Look at his line too. Yeah. Like the hairline.
Didn't Drake's dad get a tattoo of Drake's face that was not?
All right, question. What if an Amber Alert came across the screen and said that a ballistic missile was coming your way?
Mama!
It's like, okay.
Bruh. Hawaii was about to be on, like, what the fuck is going on?
They got a real Amber Alert, though?
So it wasn't even an Amber Alert.
It wasn't an Amber Alert.
It was a breaking alert.
Wow.
Every person that had a smartphone.
Wow.
A ballistic missile is headed your way.
Please take cover.
What's the first thing you do, champ?
Pray.
You buy it.
That's it. Pray. Thank you.
I don't know, bro.
No, the first thing I do is try to find Donald Dump. Fuck is wrong with this man?
Find his ass in
no, I'm
going
to find him.
That man is on the other side controlling the missile. That's where he
Let
at.
Me tell y'all something. My Jewish friend, I got some, me and my white Russian Jewish friends had a sit down at Mr. Child during the election process, right? I'm talking about this before Donald Trump won the election. And we were talking about race. Mm-hmm. And one of my Russian white Jewish partners was like, yo, he's going to be good for business. I'm like, what do you mean he's going to be good for business? Is it about business or is it about running the country? Yes, we got to have an economical stream. That's amazing, blah, blah, blah. But we were going back and forth. So one of my partners, the one I did not agree with, I mean, that I agreed with, or agreed with me, we're best buddies. He sends me this this rabbi who's preaching. And the rabbi's preaching and he's talking about Donald Trump, right? And he was saying how the Make-A-Wish Foundation, you know, had basically had a child that, you know, Make-A-Wish Foundation is here to make dreams come true for very sick kids
or
dying kids, right? So, long story short, his wish was to speak to Donald Trump. Mm. He wanted to speak to Donald Trump. And I'm like, well, what do you mean? This kid, and I'm watching, and mind you, I was confused. I was in my feelings because I'm immediately wanting to judge. I'm like, fuck Donald Trump. You don't want to talk to him. You want to meet Mickey Mouse or whatever, you know what I'm saying, going to make you feel good because he's not going to make you feel good. And apparently the child's wish was for someone to be pardoned, right? In jail, right?
Wow.
And apparently it's a big leader or somebody that's important to the whatever. And I'm texting my man, like, why are you, you know, texting me this? You know what I'm saying? Like, why are you texting? I don't want, you know what I'm saying? I don't care. Like, you know what I'm saying? But then it was about how Trump is starting to align himself, and apparently whoever he pardoned has big influence, and money is obviously part of power and influence, and this person, you know, got pardoned. You know what I'm saying? And so what I'm saying is, it's like, if the Make-A-Wish youngin' can make it to Donald Trump, I'm gonna get a message to Donald Trump.
Shit.
And when that missile come, before it come, I'm exposing Donald Trump on some level. I'm getting the jet. Listen, I'm gonna figure out how to get Donald
Trump. I'm
talking about get him.
And too vocal to get to Donald Trump. Donald don't want to hear you.
No, it might work. He's gonna reply to you on Twitter.
Okay.
Donald Trump will reply to Kenny Burns via Twitter.
But listen, you know where he's at.
Yeah.
He tweets. Do you know there's an algorithm that tell you exactly your location? You know that, right?
Correct.
Bruh, this is the conspiracy theory shit I'm talking about. This is what I'm talking about, y'all. Y'all gotta understand that there are ways to get at people.
There are.
You don't think if he got a smartphone,
you don't sound convinced.
Don't know exactly where he's at?
No, there are. I'm just saying, we talking about Donald.
But somebody gotta get him. Somebody got to get him out to office.
He should have got when he was in Atlanta. When they was over there by the block.
Somebody got to get him out of office. Hey,
he got booed like a motherfucker. Can you play that? Can you play
he
that?
He deserved it.
It's a video.
No, they had Fuck booed. Trump on the side of the
ATL.
Put that on the screen.
Yeah,
the
Mercedes-Benz
stadium.
Mm-hmm.
No, but I just, and I don't mean get God as in kill. I mean get God as in get the fuck out of the White House
either.
And get on somewhere. Actually, lock him up.
That's another way to get
him,
though.
Let's put him in prison next to Suge Knight. Let's do that. Let's lock him up for treason and put him in a cell with Suge Knight, because Suge Knight gonna do what he's supposed to do.
I was up to see how that
Trump probably owned the jail.
You said he was?
He probably owns the
several.
He best friend with the people.
Okay, speaking of somebody's pregnant, Sue Solo, I heard that Ocho Cinco.
Oh.
Ocho Cinco.
That was a rough segue.
Yeah, Ocho Cinco.
Is having a seventh child.
He is?
I didn't know he had six.
Oh, I knew that.
I didn't know that.
He a Florida boy.
Yeah, no, he's
a Florida boy. Y'all be real hot. Yeah, y'all be hot in Florida.
Ooh, okay, here we go.
Florida niggas be lit.
Yeah, it's a lot.
Something in the summer. It's that beach, man.
It's definitely the beach.
Seven kids, man.
Yeah.
He trying to deny it. What happened? I think
six baby mamas.
Something had came up. Yeah, six baby mamas. This is his seventh. He tried to deny.
Tried to deny the baby.
He tried to deny, say it wasn't his, but then the DNA test, right? Octavia Burns said,
mm-hmm. Yep.
Said that he is the father.
You are the father.
You are the father. That's, damn.
You get a nice little three paragraph. The good thing for me, my baby's looking exactly like
okay, wait, before y'all go at it, Sue Solo, can you share with Baller
Nation? Let's finish up on this Ocho Cinco situation.
Yeah,
let's before we get on Rari. All right, shout out to Miss Jenny B for Baller Alert.
Hey, Jenny.
New Baller Baby Alert. Former NFL superstar Chad Johnson, better known as Ocho Cinco, has officially admitted to fathering his seventh baby with his sixth baby mama after a one-sided legal battle over custody and support. Last year, according to The Blast, Alexi Farrakhan. I'm assuming this is her name. I'm sorry, sis. I'm so sorry. I'm sorry, Alexia. We're just going to say Alexia. filed a suit against Johnson, claiming him to be the father of her baby girl. In the suit, Alexia demanded child support, medical fees, and legal fees from Johnson. However, the former baller failed to respond. As a result, a judge awarded Alexia temporary child support from Johnson, as well as additional $5,000 for legal fees. Since then, though, Johnson has finally shown up to court to settle his paternity dispute. In the new court documents obtained by The Blast, Johnson has admitted to having a sexual relationship with Alexia, and has accepted the responsibility for his seventh child. However, Johnson is asking a judge to determine a fixed amount of child support, as he does not believe he should pay retroactive support. That's a lie.
That retro pay.
The publication reports. Okay. He also is asking a judge to toss Alexia's request for him to pay medical and legal fees, as he feels the cost should be split.
Wow.
I think that should be split, but you do owe some back pay.
Listen, put the camera on my face. Anybody need child support advice? DM me right now.
Oh,
you don't even want to start that, Ferrari.
That shit ain't no motherfucking joke. All the steps you need to take, you know what I'm saying?
Stay with your baby mom.
Definitely cheaper to keep her, but you know, you don't want to be happy. Or not happy, you know what I'm saying? Oh, hey, listen, man, that shit ain't no joke, motherfucker. Ladies, just pull out, bro. Pull out.
Okay. No.
How about wear a condom?
Wear a condom or don't have sex with somebody you don't want to fuck around and have a child with.
Don't be playing just a tip, bro. Strap up.
That's Florida shit.
Put it a little bit.
Don't do that. Don't do that either. Shit,
yo,
get
people
crazy.
People really going raw here like they're not like diseases like that can take your entirety. You know
bad,
what I mean?
Boy. It's bad too, boy.
And now it's time for Baller Mail.
Message. Okay, you guys ready for this one?
Yes.
Yeah.
Octavia Burns, you ready?
Uh-oh.
Just because you bought me a drink doesn't mean you have to be in my face all night.
Ooh.
Wow.
Mm. Get the fuck from round.
Ladies, I think we can all agree.
Can I drink in peace, motherfucker?
This was written by one of our bloggers. Female, by the way. Ladies, I think we can all agree that the worst thing a guy can do is sit, well, at least try, in your face all night after he buys you a drink.
This is a great one.
How many of us can relate? Now, fellas, don't be offended. It's flattering, to say it the least, and polite to buy a lady a drink. It is also an easy way to express your interest in a woman, and is also a great conversation starter.
Okay.
It is not, though, a pass for you to stay in a woman's face all night. Men who do that are seen as annoying and a turnoff to most women. The club and or bar scene is a place to mix, mingle, and have a good time. Save all that conversation for the first date. If a guy is kind enough to buy you a drink, though, ladies, that also doesn't give you the right to be a snob towards him either.
Hey.
It's very rude and unattractive for a woman to receive a drink and blow the buyer off right after as if he didn't just spend his hard-earned money for you. Sis, let that man shoot his shot while you while you're crushing the courage he mustered up. Without you crushing the courage he mustered up to even get your attention. Right. In a nutshell, you knew what it was when you signed up, both parties. Fellas, get the lady a drink. Ask her for her number if that's what you want to do, and continue on with your evening. Ladies, be a lady, smile and grin, and do the same. What are your thoughts?
Solo. Can't wait till my turn.
Okay. I agree. I agree with that. Like, did y'all see that video of Lil Duval and I had it there? When like a nigga approach you like this, like, can I
hit him?
Breath smelling like expired weed and shit. Ooh. Like, just if you are interested in a woman, it is so kind to buy her a drink. It is very. I don't think that there's someone gesture. that doesn't appreciate that. It's a great gesture. However, I'm not entitled to spend my evening entertaining you when I came out to mingle. Like, let's exchange contacts and we can have this conversation tomorrow. First of all, it's annoying to try to have an entire conversation with a new nigga.
Yeah.
I got where a remix, it's loud. We gonna let Kenny
go. It's so annoying. You can't converse like that. So as a woman, it feels like, okay, this nigga bought me a drink and he's trying to take me home tonight.
Right.
That's how it feels when you just pressed up on me, like, oh, you want another one? Oh, you gonna dance
that's
to this song?
That's
oh,
how
you
do
gonna...
it?
Yeah, they be like pressing their dick on it like this. Like, you be like, sir, it was a drink.
They put the dick on the
butt. It was a drink. They always do that. Yeah, they act like they walking by and they don't have space and be like, excuse me.
Have you ever felt it on your butt before?
Yes. Yes,
hey,
I have.
You.
I didn't enjoy it, but yeah, it happened.
Buy you a drink, put the dick
anyway,
on your butt.
Okay. Buy me a drink, ask for my contact, we can have this conversation.
Buy you a drink and ask you for your contact, or you with like?
Well, I mean, if your goal was to talk to me, then I would assume you would want my phone number.
So this is a little pimping for all you underage pimps out here. Underage, I mean by non-experienced.
age ain't nothing but a number.
Yeah, the issue I have, and this is an overall issue with the club now anyway, I've never seen so many niggas in a booth without an even amount of women.
Mm-hmm.
Let me rephrase that. I've never seen a booth without so many thirsty...
You mean a VIP section?
A section.
Yeah, okay. A section, yeah.
Without so many thirsty niggas trying to be around niggas.
Sausage on top
with
of
no
sausage.
Beautiful women in
the... Sausage party.
Sips cup.
Ain't nothing but a sausage party.
But that's one. Mm-hmm. That's first and foremost. Second of all, it's only right to buy a woman a drink so that your festivities can be the ultimate experience. This has nothing to do with you trying to holler, because I guarantee you, youngin', if you buy a woman a drink and it seems like nothing and your intention is to holler, by the third or fourth, if you're still not trying to holler, she's now looking at you like the gift giver.
Yeah, shoot your shot.
She wants to be in your presence at this point. And after said...
Can you put some pimp music on?
Yeah. After said accomplishment, third drink, is now in the system, now you can shoot your shot. And I mean shoot your shot by, hey, you look amazing. Is that dance really what you do? Is that dress a normal feat for you?
You know how to do that naked.
Yeah. Can you do it on the dick, though? No, I'm joking. That was just...
How we just go to Florida that fast?
We're just joking.
But no, seriously, if you're in it to win it, you have to act like it.
Yeah.
You can't just put forth the first drink and then be all up in it like these. You can't do that. You have to take your time. That's the problem with a lot of you jackrabbits anyway. And you...
They be walking up so aggressive.
You jackrabbits just be in there trying to get it quick. Take your time.
Trying to thump thump real fast.
Take your time.
Oh, hey.
Actually, wait till the fourth time you see her. How about that? Let her think about, I had the most amazing time.
You know young niggas is impatient.
Yeah, but you gotta be in it for the long haul.
That's the problem. They impatient.
The hookah is killing the party.
Stop.
The hookah is killing the party.
I got
it. Cut it out.
I got it.
Caesar.
You can always get
it.
Don't
give Caesar no mic.
Matter of fact, if you have a hookah, they come to you. Hey, can I smoke that with you?
The ones that come to you are probably not even the same ones that you would go offer a drink to.
Hookah's
so that's a totally different.
What if someone buys you a bottle?
That's sweet. I don't owe you my night.
You don't owe them the night.
I don't.
But if someone buys you a bottle, how do you feel about that?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Right. It's not a little bit extra right, thank you because
no, right, right, no, right, thank right, you. You don't owe me. I don't owe you the rest of my night.
That's a bigger gesture to be.
Hey,
if they buy you a
box. Nah, it doesn't. That just shows his tax bracket. He's willing to, or how ignorant he is. He's either willing to spend money he don't got, or he don't care about spending the money that he does. That doesn't mean that he's.
So you don't look at the guy differently if he buys you a regular drink or a bottle.
Lord, it could be. It depends on the situation, Rari.
Okay, I'm just asking.
Some niggas, you know, just want to buy bottles because that's what they do. It's happened.
I've seen motherfuckers. Like, ooh, he bought me a bottle.
Yeah, because they don't know no better. Like you,
ladies, if a like, bottle impresses you, you have a bottle, no chance.
Like, come on, yeah. Like, you praising the bottle. The man might even know the damn owner. He probably got it for cost price.
Ooh.
Why you, I mean, calm down, sis. Oh,
you're giving away the secrets.
I'm just saying,
so what
sis.
You're, wait. So we just ooh. Broke something mm-hmm. to Baller Nation. So what you're saying is that some of these men
mm-hmm.
that are buying these bottles, they know the club owner
mm-hmm.
and they're getting them at cost?
More than likely.
So if they're getting them at cost, which is $29
not
a bottle
much.
For rosé. And they order 30, that means that they're really spending under $1,000 for 30 bottles of champagne?
And they're probably not even tipping the 20% gratuity on the actual price.
Oh, and wait.
Like that's the fucked up part, too.
Wait, they do not tip?
Not accordingly, no.
Where they do that at?
In these streets.
Ooh, don't say no clubs or nobody at this panel.
In these streets.
Don't you say no club name.
Listen.
Wow. So the marketing is real.
Oh, no, it's very real. And it's fine. I just don't want the women to take this stuff the wrong way. Girl, it's alcohol. It's a drink at the end of the day.
At the end of the
day. It's a drink.
It's something that can make you do something you don't want to do.
That's correct. It. It's a drink.
Okay. Good answer.
Mm-hmm.
Great answer. Give it up for my dear sister, Susan, in the building. Love you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Underscore.
Love you.
Underscore.
Underscore. Underscore. Solo. Thank you.
Especially on the frauds.
That was a very popular ball of mail. Keep the ball of mails coming. I think it was like 30 of those.
Wow.
You be getting hit.
Yeah, they be killing me on
this. What else do they give you? Yeah, what else happens in there? Like, do they send you something and be like, hey, how would you act in this situation?
Man, I got this one DM, bro.
Talk to us.
Over this past weekend.
She was coming at you?
Yeah.
She wanted
had a lot of cushion for the pushing, but you know.
Well,
she's a little light skinned.
How about to say, was she chocolate enough for you?
She need to be.
She can tan.
Black.
She can tan.
Okay, and now it's time for Common Creeping.
Creep. And from his full time. Creep.
Yes. Okay.
Woo!
The Real Housewives of Atlanta.
This shit lit.
It's pretty lit.
They tried.
Okay.
They tried.
If you guys saw the latest episode, Kim is really, since she's been back, it's just been a lot.
Kim Zolciak.
Yeah, it's been a lot with Kim. So anyway, Candy tweets, I'm sick of these bitches lying on me at Kim Zolciak. I have never wanted your box. Wanted you or your box.
Hey.
And stop swearing on your kids while you're telling lies, lying ass bitch.
Ooh.
Somebody's really reaching for a permanent peach here.
Okay.
This is my house. You're just a visitor. Of course, NeNe had to jump in on that and say Kim Zolciak is always lying.
Wow.
Pinocchio emoji. Kim Zolciak responds.
Uh-oh, she says I'm back.
Mm-hmm. If anybody is lying, it's you, Candy. You and your husband are full of swingers, fucking all kinds of girls,
ooh.
And can never admit it.
Ooh.
And bitch, if it weren't for me, there would be no house. Remember, I built this house.
Ooh.
Bitch,
Candy,
she didn't say
a
the bitch part
booty.
At the end. But,
Ty, what's
but
up, big bro?
That's how
bad.
It felt when I read it.
I just did it for work.
Hey, no.
Listen, I think Kim has been on swole since she got back. Like, it's
ooh.
Like
oh, yeah.
Kim Zolciak. She has literally just been like... attacking everybody at every moment. Like, it's not even necessary for her to do that. I think people already enjoy her on the show before she was gone. So for her to come back and like go off on Kenya, talk shit about Port. Well, now she's best friends with Port. It's just weird.
The whole house.
These are some grown ass. Well, I don't understand what's going on. I think Candy is probably, I love Candy. I think if Candy does whatever the hell she does, it's not like she has
ever. Do you have any of her toys?
No, I don't.
Okay.
No, I'm not really a sex toy person.
Okay.
Kim's husband still play?
No.
Yeah.
Somebody reaching for a peach.
Yeah.
She's definitely reaching for a peach. It's too much. It's too much. It's really extra, and we don't need it. Atlanta's already coming.
But those shows are all built on the bullshit. You know what I'm talking about?
People like
it
that.
Is. It's entertaining. It's definitely entertaining.
Because whatever Candy and Todd's preference is their preference. I mean,
absolutely.
But then why would you?
But I feel like Candy's gonna break. Candy not gonna take this for too long. Like I really think Candy's gonna end up like swinging Candy on somebody very soon.
But I'm just trying to figure out. Wasn't there some episodes before that involved Candy and Portia with the whole box situation?
Yeah, yeah,
that was like last season, right?
That was what. What's her name? Oh my Jesus!
Oh,
Phaedra. Tried to stir some shit up and say that Candy tried to drug Portia and drag her into her and Todd's sex dungeon. That Candy denies.
Man, sex dungeon, bro.
Hey,
shit.
Yo, this has nothing to do with Candy and Todd, but there is some real underground freak shit.
Yeah,
that's going on in this industry.
Fifty Shades of Grey is such a huge thing. It's such a huge.
I've never
got a whole ass sex room.
I've never seen anything. Right, but until last night, he had her handcuffed and he was banging her front. I was like, hold on, babe, did you see?
Because
you know how, like, you do the guy.
Say what?
What? No. But you know how you're the guy, you can still see what happens on the channel. And I'm just, the football game's over. By the way, the football play, we got to talk about that. But I'm scrolling past because the football game is, and I'm like, oh shit, 50 Shades Darker. And I'm like, oh shit. I was like, babe, did you see that? I'm tapping my wife like, yo, did you see that? He got her tied up. He banging her from the side. And I'm like, oh shit, hold on. Where's Kyle? Is he upstairs? Kyle, go to the entertainment room. Like, no, it was a whole thing.
He got a whole room. I mean, people enjoy, you know, sex in different ways. And I think if that's what they do, that's what they do. Don't try to make
shame
them, you know.
At all. But I also believe if you're down with the shits, you might not want to know them publicly, but if you are down with the shits, you can just like, okay, I said
it. If it comes out publicly, then what?
That's all I'm saying.
What's the big deal?
I think it's just the way that they are, like that.
The way Kim is saying it.
The crew gets messy sometimes, and it's out of line. It's like, girl, you just got back. Like, why are you coming for me?
So, yeah, I get it.
Yeah.
I believe in free spirits and doing what you love to do. You know what I'm saying?
I'm with that.
Yeah. Okay, great.
Mm-hmm.
That's all you got
to
say?
Yeah, let's just go to the football game now before y'all.
Oh, yeah, big shout out to the boy, what's his name, Diggs? Was the receiver.
Before you even get to that, I'm glad the Falcons lost.
This sucks.
Because I would have been really upset had we would have went to the NFC Championship, won, and then went to the Super Bowl, and then lost. So I'm glad we lost this
one. So you're glad that we didn't even get a chance?
First of all, I want to talk about that Falcons thing one time, and I'm going to get off of it. Jones could have caught that last pass.
I know, that shit.
Damn, and I want him to be great. And he is great. He's going to be an all-time Hall of Famer by the time it's done. But I wanted him to catch that pass.
Man, bad.
That would have took him from...
I know.
It just took him to the most elite, you know, wide receiver game. But anyway, Stephon Diggs caught that pass.
Last play of the game, bro. All you had to do was tackle him.
First of all, he was worried about hitting him when it don't matter. The game was over. Even if you got a penalty.
Let me set it up for you, OG. Clock strike zero. The play is going. All you have to do is tackle the man so you can play cover prevent. Go all the way back, bro.
Yeah, I didn't know the terminology.
Let him catch the ball and then just tackle him. He went for some...
Oh,
man.
And I think
he's a rookie, though. So.
It's old, but it was phenomenal. One of the biggest plays. It's old news as of right now. But it's one of the most phenomenal plays. It happened since our last episode, and I wanted to share. But the biggest thing is that they might go to the Super Bowl. And guess where the Super Bowl is?
Minnesota.
And you got to stay tuned, y'all.
They got to beat the Eagles.
I'm hosting the biggest party.
It's a lot of Havishans in Minnesota.
I'm hosting the biggest party in Super Bowl.
I might need to go and find me a Havishan man.
Yeah, y'all definitely can come. Oh, it's a lot of Havishans in Minnesota?
Yeah, I'm trying to go get me a Havishan man.
Okay, so Sunday night.
We're going to put that in the calendar.
Of the Super Bowl, we're hosting.
We are coming with you.
You're coming with me.
Mm-hmm. Robin.
So the Nice and Burn show.
Robin.
We've had enough. I don't even want to work. I'm just coming.
Yeah, you should come.
Robin.
Yeah.
I'll work.
So the Nice and Burn show is doing a party with Puff Daddy, Khaled, French Montana.
Let me look up these flags.
And Cardi B.
Okay.
It's going to be the biggest party of Super Bowl.
ATL to
so
Minnesota.
If you're kind of on a fence about going to Minnesota.
Don't be anymore.
Does Delta go to Minnesota?
Delta goes
Delta
everywhere.
Goes What's
everywhere.
Minnesota's airport?
I don't know.
Minneapolis.
Just type it in. Okay.
Minneapolis.
What's that?
Okay, we'll figure it out. And now it's time for Confucius Says. Confucius Says. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for a Wee Fucius moment. Jessica Burns writes on her golden guidance, focusing on what you don't have, who doesn't like or support you, and the negative aspects of your past is a waste of creative energy. You cannot manifest a positive life with a negative mindset. Choose yourself, honor your experiences, accept where you are, and move forward with gratitude for change.
Nice.
And I wanted to read that because so many people focus on the bullshit. Focus on things that make no never mind in their particular lives. But yet you want to give things energy. Giving things energy does what? It brings it to life. Mm-hmm. It gives it a platform to stand on. But ignoring the bullshit, staying clear of the bullshit, and most importantly, staying sucker free will get you to the promised land. Mm-hmm. In honor of the Honorable Dr. Martin Luther King, go forth out there, y'all. He had a dream, and the dream is real. Baller Alert Radio, we love you. Baller Nation, we'll see you next week.
Peace.
Baller Alert.
The dream is real.